Hey guys, what's up? Today we are going to draw a cartoon girl. In our last lesson, we drew a cartoon boy. Now, if you missed that lesson, you can still check it out on this channel. So grab your pencil, grab your paper, or if you have an iPad, you could grab your iPad and you can use Procreate. That's the app that I use, Procreate. Okay, so let's get to it. Let's draw our cartoon girl. Now, the first thing we need to do is to draw an oval like this. Doesn't have to be perfect. It doesn't have to be perfect, just an oval like this. Okay, so afterwards, let's draw a shape like this. Below, okay, our oval. You got that? All right. This oval would represent the head, and hair would represent the girl's dress. Okay? All right. So, we're going to draw a shape like this hair, and another one like this hair. This would represent the sleeves, her sleeves of her shirt. Okay? Afterwards, let's draw one, two, three, four lines like this here. Okay, this would represent her legs. All right. Now, let me zoom in on this for you right now so that you can see what we're going to do now. Okay. We're going to have two curvy lines like this here. And we're going to put this here and this here. Okay. This would represent her socks. Okay. So, let's work on her feet right now. All right. So, one hair and a shape like this hair. Okay, you have that. Now we're just going to add two buckles on her shoe. Okay. Let me zoom in on that for you to see. Okay. One, two. All right. Okay. So we have her dress, her legs, her feet, socks, everything. Okay. How does she look? All right. So we want her arms and her hand to be behind her back. All right. So we're just going to draw a curve like this here and a curve like this here. Okay. All right. So let's start focusing on her head, on the head. Okay. Let me zoom in on that for you. Okay, so what we're going to do, all right, we're going to draw a C, the letter C, like this here, one A, a reverse C, the other A. And we're just going to draw two lines here. Let's give it some more definition. All right, okay. And now, let's start focusing on her hair. So, follow with me. A line like this here. And another one like this hair. Hey, relax, Mario. Okay, so what we're gonna do now, the eyes. All right, okay, so circle or oval. Okay, another circle right here. And filled up circle here or oval, dark. All right, yours could be circle or it could be oval, it can be an egg shape. I mean, it's up to you. All right, okay. So, we're going to do her eyelid. All right, so a line like this here. Okay. I had to extend on that to make the lash, you know, her eyelash. Yeah. Okay. Like this here. All right, okay. So, let's work on the eyebrows where we're just going to have one line here. And another one here. Okay. Now, the nose. What we're going to do for the nose, okay, we're just going to do an incomplete triangle like this. Why should I say that's these mathematical more than or less than signs? Okay. All right. So, we have the eyes, the nose, eyebrows, everything. Her face is coming to shape, okay? So, now we're missing the mouth, okay? So we're going to give her a smile. If you'd prefer, you want to upside down smile, make her sad. But we don't want her to be sad. Okay? We want her to be happy. Give a little something to represent her cheeks right here. Okay, how does that look? Fine. Okay, so we have our girl here, but we want her to have some more hair. Okay, so what I'm going to do, I'm going to give her two little afro puffs. Okay, so we're gonna just add one hair and another one hair. Okay, how does she look? Okay, now we know some girls like to accessorize. All right, so let's add a little earring here and one hair and another one hair. Okay, and on her dress is too plain. We're gonna add a little design on that. So we're gonna just gonna put a flower circle, petals. Okay, and we have a little sunflower on her dress. Now she is not now she is not floating, she's supposed to be on a surface. So we use a line here, okay, to represent the horizon, to show that she's on a surface. Okay, now when we're done, if we need to, we darken our edges so that we can see what's going on with our girl here. All right. Okay, we can even add some more definition to the hair. Okay, all right. Okay, let's Mario get away. Oops. Okay, and all right, so let's start shading up the hair. That's what we can do. Da 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 da. One tie, this hair, and da 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 da. Shading up, shading up, shading up, shading up. Da 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 da. Okay, so we have our girl. Let's darken this area here. Sometimes there's a technique that cartoonists use. They darken the edge around is the darkest. Okay, so you just darken all the outside areas, not the inner ones, the outside ones, to give your character some more appeal. Okay. I'm sure you noticed that drawing is all about making mistakes and correcting those mistakes while you go. I don't like using the eraser. I just draw lines over the lines to correct them. All right, it's all about making mistakes. All right, and if you notice, I pass the darker lines on them and then, okay, it gives it some more appeal, okay? I'm missing one thing to do. I need to sign my work. Okay, because I am proud of my work. And you need to sign your work too. Because I know your work looks good and you should be proud of your work. So until next time, guys, I will see you in our next lesson. And don't forget to like, share, subscribe. Bye, guys.